Hey everybody, I'm Heather. I'm an animal communicator and energy intuitive, and this is Tober, the oracle dog, who is now a dog in spirit, but he lived with me up until 2019 and left the 3D world when he was 19 years old. He's super connected to the energetic field, both in the spiritual realm, the universal realm, and also in the 3D world. And he is going to share thoughts, words, images, feelings, and know-how, which I will convert into words as we go through this reading. And he also, there's a photo here, he also loves to be able to connect and share his wisdom on a personal level with yourself. So if you do get any hits, like things that pop into your head, images that flash through your mind as we're going through the reading, there's a substantial chance Tober is actually connecting to you directly, so it is worth taking note of some of those as well. Okay, so this is a pick a pile reading, and we're going to have three piles today, and we are going to be asking for advice from your future self. So Tober will be working with your future self to bring you advice, and that's pile number one. This is pile number two. And I can see it there. That's pile number three. And we have got for pile number one, trust the niggle. What is the niggling feeling trying to tell you? And for pile number two, we have no, wait, postpone, pause, say no. And for pile number three, we have answer the call. What is your soul calling you to do? Sorry, I couldn't see that. Okay, so those are the three cards, and I will give you a moment, and then we will be asking Tober for advice from your future self. Okay. Hi, pile number one. You chose this lovely card, Trust the Niggle. What is the niggling feeling trying to tell you? Okay, so we're going to be starting by, I've got some channeled cards where Tober has worked with the universal energy for areas where humans, animals perceive humans to have some energy blocks. So your future self and Tober have been drawn to ask me to pull one of these overall theme cards for the reading. Okay, so if your theme is about purpose, so trust the niggle, that has something theme-wise to do with your purpose. So we're going to be pulling in two more oracle cards and some tarot cards. Oh, there's one come tumbling out. Displacement. Okay, so I'm already getting the feeling that whatever it is that you're doing isn't feeling right for you. So your purpose, there's something going on work-wise or just life path. Shine, may you be a lighthouse. Okay, pile number one, I feel that you're feeling anything but shining. I think you have not got a feeling of having a guiding light in front of you, as in a guiding light of something that you feel very passionate that you can work towards. I'm just going to draw one more oracle card. I was only going to do three, but I'm feeling very called to do a fourth one. Just having a look around to see which one Tober wants. It's one of these, I think. There it is. Sacred gratitude, reverent appreciation, prayer. Okay. Okay, I think that you are, I think you're doing something that is, I think you feel grateful for having the purpose that you currently have. And when I mean purpose, it could be job, it could be role, it could be so the image that's coming through to me is like a mum who has children, and you're very grateful for the children, and it's a huge gift, but there's a niggle about who are you in that. There's also something coming through about being being part of a couple, a partnership, and you're very grateful for your partner. You know, there's a lot of love. but sometimes you feel that you're displacing who you are in order to meet the needs of the partnership, and maybe there's things that you would like to do. So I'm guessing the example of traveling more, but your partner doesn't like traveling, and so you're compromising just a bit too much. So you're feeling that your life purpose is just kind of on hold, I think. Okay, let me get some tarot cards just to confirm this, and then we'll be asking for some advice from your future self. A chariot, okay, there's definitely a wanting to move forward. I really do feel that you're feeling a bit stuck, and a bit stuck because of other people's needs, which you're grateful for having them. Eight of voices, so there's some obstacles going on for you. Guilt. You've got guilt going on. Not a good emotion. Not a good emotion, part number one. We don't do guilt, do we, Tober? We've done guilt in the past and we've learned to let it go, because it doesn't serve any purpose except the person who holds it. Knight of Cups and Five of Wands. Okay, this is just confirming the same energy I'm getting. Pile number one, I'm feeling very strongly that you feel grateful for how and what you have, who you have around you, what your current purpose is, and whether that's working, whether that's working as a mother, you know, being a mother, which is a job, or being a father. I do apologize. I'm just getting an image of a mother with children from Tober. But it could easily be a father with children, and your role is to look after the children, and you love it. You're so grateful for the time that you're able to spend doing whatever it is that you're doing, or doing it with the people that you're doing it with. But you've lost you somewhere in that. You're feeling a little bit, you're feeling like you'd want a bit more romance in your life, romance about you, romance about some dreams that you want to have fulfilled. And you want some more excitement. I think you'd like a little bit of a rockier ride. But in order to get there, you feel like you'd have to put people out of sorts and rock the boat, instigate some change that may end up in you sacrificing the lovely things that you do feel, because you really do feel grateful for what you've got. But you also feel displaced from being yourself. And that's, it's just not, it's not a combination that's sitting well for you. It's not a combination that's sitting in balance. And it's starting to build up that there's a bit of a pressure starting to build up about this. You know, the niggle's becoming more of a niggle. It's starting to feel like a barrier. It's starting to feel like something that wants to burst through you. Okay, we're going to... that's the overall energy I'm getting. We're going to now connect to Tober and your future self and see what advice they want to bring forward. Okay, so we are going to... We get advice from your future self. Take a risk. Wow, okay. Step out of your comfort zone. Feeling safe and secure is a wonderful experience, but if we remain in our safe zone for fear of change, we create a limiting and restrictive environment that can ultimately lead to stagnation and loss of our creative potential to manifest our greatest contribution in the world. Sorry, that was really bad reading of that. I think I need glasses. Let go of fear and take a risk. This is a real invitation from an advice from your future self that carrying this energy for much longer is not going to really work for you. And they're saying that if you do take a risk, you know, you're not going to lose the good bits of what you have. All you'll do is enhance the bits that don't quite work for you. Okay, what would you give? What would you need to give up in order to achieve your dream? And I'm honestly getting the sense of not very much. I think it's more a question of finding space and treating, you know, treating everybody is about, you can put everybody first. You don't have to put, say, your children or someone else's needs first. You can prioritize yourself too as equal, and prioritize the time that you need for yourself as being equally important as everyone else's. Loyalty, your reliability demonstrates your loving sense of devotion and consistency of being. Yeah, pile number one, you are really, really devoted and you're really loyal. And I think you feel that you would be letting people down if you didn't continue to provide the amount of space for people that you do. And you can do that, but just do it in a slightly different way that puts in a little bit better boundaries. And actually you kind of need to let other people take ownership of their own space too, to give you your own space. So that you can follow some of your own purpose. You know, going off and doing things on your own is not a bad thing. It strengthens you and it strengthens the bonds with the people that you love. Partly because it makes them slightly less reliant on you and partly because it gives them a little bit of space. And actually everybody benefits when we all create, what's the right word? The sort of magnetic power that comes with being true to our own inner desires as well. So I think this is really clear, pile number one. There's some very black and white advice from your future self that there's a purpose in life that you feel is a little bit lacking, and it's causing you to not shine. And it is about trusting the niggle, and it's about taking a risk of displacing yourself, because you're not going to displace other people. You're just not, because who you are when you show up and how you hold space for people is just amazing. And no one's not going to be there, and no one's going to do anything other than probably say, gosh, we've been telling you this for ages. You know, you need to make a bit more time for yourself. We'll be okay. We'll be fine. And actually, you know what, we might even thrive, but not that we are going to thrive and then not want you back. It just means that everybody's going to be happy, and the energy of you being happier is going to make everyone else happier. Yeah, I think that was really clear. I hope that really helps, pal number one. Do please give Tober a thumbs up and subscribe if you like our channel and you haven't already joined us. We're reasonably new, and we're just absolutely loving doing this work. Connecting to the animals and the universe in this way for me is an absolute joy, and I'm so grateful, and I'm very grateful for your support, and thank you. Hope to see you again. Okay, bye. Hey, pile number two, you chose the card no. Wait, postpone, pause, say no. So we're going to pull an overall theme, energy theme card that will just give us some guidance about what your future self wants to talk about. So Tober, which card, please? Okay. Trust. Okay. No and trust. It kind of says don't trust, but let's not preempt that. Okay, so I'm going to pull some oracle cards and see what comes up. Okay, so we have... We're also getting trust yourself to say no. Battle. Okay. Okay. I'm kind of feeling that you trust that if you don't say no, you're going to end up in a battle or something. And maybe you struggle with being able to say no. Imagine. May you look beyond what can't be seen. And both of those, okay. Healing the heart, the power of self-love and divine mother, nurturing compassion, grace. Okay, let me just line these up, make sure we can see them, and then there's room. Okay, pile number two. So there's a situation going on here. And Toby's showing me that you have a real handle on what's going on. You've got a much higher perspective than everybody else, and it's like you're the grounding energy for a particular situation, or you're grounded enough to see. You're grounded enough to see that something that's going on in the direction of travel is going the wrong way. And straight off, that the your future self is saying, trust that you're right. And put the brakes on, or put the brakes on as well, or don't get involved. Don't get involved. Somebody or something or some kind of situation is dragging you down a route, or you're feeling dragged down a route that isn't the right thing for you. It's just not. You don't feel nurtured, you wouldn't feel nourished. You would end up giving a lot of yourself away. And it's a very specific circumstance. It's like the people involved are just so entwined in what's going on, and just so wrapped up and involved in it, that they just can't see beyond their solutions being the right one. And you can see that. It's really, really clear to you that it's just not right for really anybody. And you kind of, I think, you feel like drawn into nurturing and, oh, this sweet little one, it's going to go for two, but we'll go for three. I think you feel like you want to nurture and soothe everybody, like say no, this isn't the right way to do it, and let's come at this with love, let's not go into battle with each other. But it's not going to make any difference. Your future self is saying to you that sometimes you just have to let people fight their battles and not get dragged into it, and also trust that it'll work out, trust that it'll work out for other people. But really, really, really clear advice from your future self is don't get involved. Okay, the Chariot came out as the first card in our number one, so there might be some additional messages for you in there. Four of Inspiration and Page of Inspiration. You're a very collaborative person, pile number two. You want everyone to get on. And you can see really clearly that if a different path was travelled, that there would be a much more nourishing outcome. Everybody would get their needs met. Everybody would feel happy. This Page of Inspiration and Imagine underneath each other is, very much that, there could be a fresh start. There could be, there really could be something that'd be just much more inspiring, just much more aspiring, and much more playful, and just a much happier way to deal with a situation, whatever it is, whatever this situation is. I love how these lining up. I think your future self is actually saying, "Run a mile, literally run in the other direction. Whatever is going on, just trust your instinct and stay away." Because it's just. There we go. People just can't see. They can't see beyond the door. They just can't see beyond it. Oh, yeah, here we go. You're the voice of reason. You're trying to balance everybody. You're trying to be the voice of reason. You're trying to stop this battle from happening, whatever it is. Two or three people are destined to fall out. And it gives you a lot of pain. And you want to pour love into this situation, and all it is going to do is drain you. Your instincts to look after everybody is so strong, but you also have this real you need to trust this advice from your future self. that's what the message I'm getting through from Tober and from your future self, which is you kind of know that it's just not worth getting involved, and you kind of know that it's going to go through whatever process it's going to go through. And your future self is saying, even though you can see you know, the likely outcome, and even though you can see it's not in everybody's highest good, and even though you have, you know, the ability to try and help everybody to be collaborative and come at this with a much more sort of, you know, playful attitude that you can see behind the door that everyone else can't see, turn the other way and just get yourself out of this particular, just don't get involved. Just turn the other way for the time being. Yeah, that's it. It's quite simple. Okay, part number two. And I'm sorry, you know, it's sad if it's people that you care about and you don't want to see them do this, then you know, that's hard, because all you want to do is help them see the love for the situation in each other. There you go. Kindness changes everything. You want to pour kindness on people, but it's just, do we want one of these? No, sorry, that was me. Thanks, Tober. Yeah, your future self is saying, you know, the kindest thing in this situation is to just keep yourself, look after yourself and the self-love. And actually, you'll be stronger for people on the other side who, when they come to you licking their wounds, you know, you'll have more capacity and more emotional space to help everybody. The secret of getting ahead is getting started. Yeah, start walking in the other direction and get ahead of the battle. get ahead of the game. And you are unique. Yeah, you can see things that other people can't see, and so you want to help people sort it out, but sometimes they have to do and learn the hard way. And as I said, you'll be there to pick up the pieces. Okay, number two, that was really short and sweet. I hope this resonates. Yeah, good luck with whatever the situation is that's going on. And I hope you don't get embroiled in it. There's a good chance you might get dragged in. Yeah, trust that it will work out. It will work out. And that's what your future self is telling you. Okay, thank you very much. If you'd like to like, subscribe, say thank you to Tober, that would be amazing. We're a new channel and we're just loving doing this work. We adore and are so appreciative of the affirmations that we're receiving from everybody. Yeah, we hope to see you again in the future. Okay, thank you. Bye. Hey, pile number three, you chose the card, answer the call. What is your soul calling you to do? And we are going to ask your future self with Tober to pull a theme card for this particular reading. So these are channels themed cards from Tober about areas that humans have energy blocks in. Or not, as the case may be. Unstoppable. Wow, answering the call. What's your soul calling you to do? Your future self is wanting to talk to you within the theme of unstoppable. Amazing. Okay, let's get some cards. I'm excited about this reading. I can feel the energy already. Okay, Tober, we can ask card number three's future self for which cards they'd also like to work with. Is that one there? There's that one. Commitment. Okay. Third, may your brave call be carried on the wind. Look at this. We've got answer the call and brave call. I just adore working with cards like this. It never ceases to amaze me, the energy and the synchronicities and how these messages come flowing out. So we've got two answering the call or hearing the call. Okay, which extra card please, Tober, from pile number three's future self? Oh, there it is. We've got two. It's not that one, but it is that one. Clarity, planning and releasing illusion, and building your world, creation, expansion, networking. Okay, pile number three, the words are flashing through my head from Tober saying destiny awaits, your future is calling, your future self is calling. I'm feeling that you know what this is. Obviously, it's a general reading. It's going to be different for everybody. But I am getting the impression, pile number three, that you have absolute clarity about, you have a calling. I think you've launched into it. You're very, very, like, you know, a million percent committed. You've heard and answered your own calling to step forward into this, to build a new wealth for yourself. And your future self is saying you're going to be unstoppable. It's kind of a given. So there's some advice that's needed. So we need to understand what this is. Because with the overall, this is the overall energy and also an affirmation. This is really exciting. I feel so happy for you. I'm literally smiling. I've sort of got almost like butterflies in my stomach of excitement for you. The Chariot. I don't believe this. The Chariot has come out as the first card, as the first tarot card in all three piles today. So, I mean, there could be some extra messages in each. I wonder whether this is just like almost like a storyboard today. And it's the first card. Amazing. Okay, so there's a journey. Like there's a you're en route. You're answering the call. And a commitment, and you're very, very inspired. It's happening fast. And this is the inspiration. Is the Knight of Wands, which is you're chasing your dreams. You're manifesting your dreams, and you're just going at it with courage and commitment. It's amazing. So this is all affirmations. We still haven't got the advice bit, but I'm sure we'll get there. And we maybe just need a bit more. And do the advice on the next round of cards. I've got two. They do want to come out. We'll go with the two. Seven of Cups. Okay, so you have a few choices. Here we go. We're getting into the advice now. There's a little bit of say not indecision, isn't it? You're not a person who's indecisive. I think it's what to do first. All of these are really important, and you're going to achieve all of them, but I think there's a little bit of what to do first. Okay, King of Pentacles. So the advice coming through then is that... I'm just getting very strong. You actually know what to do first. You really do. You plan this. You're feeling in the middle of this reading, you are feeling unstoppable, but actually something's holding you back a little bit. Seven of Pentacles, you've set all the seeds in motion. It's you've got it. Like you've got everything that you need. Okay, what other messages are coming through? I think pile number three, this is relevant for some of you, but I think you have been I think this is in progress. This is, you know, you've answered your calling, you committed to it. I think that you've had a couple of there's a couple of things that you maybe in your plan, like there's a big plan going on here. But maybe things aren't happening in the sequence that you expect them to. Or maybe there's a couple of things that have you sort of set in motion, but they've not delivered in the same way that you thought that they would, but other things are. So it's not like your overall plan, your overall calling isn't working. It's just that a couple of avenues or a couple of aspects of what it is that you're wanting to do, or you're doing rather, haven't quite come out as you expected so far. And the advice from Spirit is just chill. It's all going to work. The whole lot, everything that you've planned, everything that you have put into this, everything that you've dreamed about this building your world, about creating this fabulous aspect of yourself, or this project, or this new business. It could be it could be family, I suppose, building a family. Something hasn't quite got off exactly, like you've got this great big master plan, probably in your head, maybe on paper, but definitely in your head. You just kind of expected everything to run in a certain way. And there's just been a couple of things that have wobbled. And it's making you kind of know that you're unstoppable, but it's making you kind of held back. And the advice from your future self is just chill. Just you know, everything will work out. It just might not work out in the same way. You know, if you think about nature and seasons, you know, sometimes some seeds grow really well one year, and then the next year, for absolutely no reason whatsoever, they don't grow so well, but something else grows really, really well. And in the end, everything grows, but like some years some things grow faster than others. There seems to be no natural reason for it. And there's something about the environment, there's something about the growing conditions, there's something about the soil, the water, the air, the fertilizer, the nutrition that is different one year to the next. And therefore there's a difference in how quickly things come to fruition. And your future self is just saying, it's all going to work out. It's all in hand. It's all clear. And, you know, sometimes you have to, you're saying here, you know, you've put all the planning in, but you kind of have to release control, release the illusion that everything will happen in exactly the way that you've expected it to. Because nature, who is nourishing this, you know, the air that we breathe, the energy that we have in around us, you know, I'm not saying that this is something that's growing nature, but nature, it provides the nourishment that allows us all to exist, including our projects. And so there's a little bit of you that is thinking that everything should work out exactly the way that you have planned it. But that's just, it's just not going to be like that. And it's never going to be like that. It will mostly, because you're good at predicting. But it's just relax. It's all going to work out. Everything's going to work out. Look, you've got your watchdog looking after you. I love this color. It reminds me of Tober hanging out with you, saying, it's all under control. Don't you worry. You dreamed your dreams. We know exactly what you want, and we're nourishing it. Look, there's the plant here is going from small, and you're nurturing it to sitting back and letting the universe nurture it. And then that will help build your world. Okay, that's really clear. Pile number three. Whatever you're doing, you are unstoppable. But relax and chill, and let nature and the universe also help you with that unstoppableness. You're on a big journey, and you're on a huge journey. It's really exciting. It's really exciting. You've listened to yourself. When you listen to yourself and you listen to your inner voice, the universe starts to make things happen really, really quickly. But then we do have to let go of some of the detail of the control about the sequence of the things happen. I was going to get you a dream your dreams, but I think you're already dreaming your dreams. Oh, I will pull one just because I've got them in my hand. Yeah, I will pull one. Say thank you to others as often as you can. Say thank you to life. Say thank you to yourself. Gratitude allows you to trust life, and trust is the foundation for dreams coming true. Okay. That's what we're saying. The universe is saying, is just relax and let the universe deal with some of the detail of this, because your master plan is unstoppable. It is going to deliver. I was going to get a couple of other cards. What are we going to get? Some, what ones? Let's get some of these. Actually, no, sorry. I'm going to get an Abraham Hicks one. Abraham Hicks Abundance. There we go. Oh, look, see, you're unstoppable. They're flying out. There's loads of abundance which is coming your way. And these are very energy-tuned cards. Okay, we've already had this one in another pile as well. And money is not the root of evil or of happiness. The important subject of money and financial success is not the root of all evil, as many have quoted, nor is the path to happiness. So when you're able to successfully control something like the subject of money that affects you most of you all day, every day, you will have accomplished something rather significant. For not only is it certain that your financial success must improve, but the evidence of that success will then prepare you for deliberate improvement in every aspect of your life experience. Okay, so the King of Pentacles is about getting the ultimate sort of rewarded state. And the advice from your future self is that abundance is unstoppable in this scenario, but the emotional abundance that you're going to feel from walking your own path and delivering your own calling, that's an even richer experience for you. The key here is just to enjoy the journey of it being delivered, not the craving for a certain element of it, and let the universe do its job. Take your hands off the wheel a little bit, and keep the vision going. They can work to your vision. Okay, amazing. How exciting. I wonder what you're actually, I wonder what you're up to, pile number three. If you heard and are answering your own calling, that's a really, really amazing place to be. And I'm really, really happy for you. Okay, if you like what we do, do please like and subscribe, give Tober a thumbs up, and maybe come back and visit us again another time. We adore doing these readings. We've only been going about 3 or 4 weeks, maybe 4 or 5 weeks now. It's just such a pleasure and a delight to talk to you all, get the amazing feedback that we're getting, and also just my pleasure as the communicator to be able to bring this incredible information from Tober and the energy field, and in this case, your future self. So all the best to you, pile number three. Thank you very much.